Cole, why do you think it's important for technology to be used in the classroom, and how does that help students learn better or become better citizens?
I think that will help the students learn better because for some students, I know it's boring for them to use it on paper and pencil all the time. So I think it's a cool opportunity that for kids that don't have technology at home to be able to use technology at school to help with their learning.
And why do you like technology?
Because it's interesting and I know a lot about it. Yeah.
You like discovering things, figuring things out?
Mm-hmm.
Yeah, okay.
Ms. Coffey, why do you think every classroom should have the opportunity to use or have an Apple TV?
Well, I think an Apple TV is important for three reasons. Well, mainly because it makes the iPads more mobile. I use it with my iPads.
Yeah.
But for one, the kids can be holding the iPad and the teacher can walk around and teach an app, for example. Another thing the kids love is that you can put their movies or their book creator, whatever they made, pop it right up to the screen. Also, you can walk around like a chalkboard almost, and as you're teaching, the kid can write, the student can write, and everyone can see it, and it can be passed around. So it just makes everything more mobile and easier to manage.
Yeah, I agree with that.
Yeah? Okay. You have one?
No.
No. But you think your classroom should have one?
Yeah.
Okay. Yes. I think every classroom would benefit from an Apple TV.
If I was learned anything in third grade, that would be...
it's that kids can do amazing things when given the time.
I've learned to have a growth mindset, not a fixed one, and that's what I've learned in third grade.
How to do better on writing.
That Miss Brown's a really good teacher.
If I've learned anything in third grade, it's if something doesn't go your way, don't cry about it.
How to write essays and how to work in teams.
Leaders and
multiplication and division.
I learned the Gallon Kingdom.
I learned coding.
The best thing I've learned in third grade is how to make new friends.
I learned strategies to divide.
One thing that I've learned is strategies to complete work.
I have lots of friends.
I learned this year how to improve even when you think it's the best it can be.
If I learned anything in third grade, it's that our teachers here at Oxford are awesome. Number two, I learned how to add fractions.
I love my Indian series.
I like vocab rather than spelling.
I've learned to be kind to my friend and have a better attitude.
That I can push myself as a reader.
What is your favorite part about being a producer in the newsletters?
I like, I've usually, when I was in, before I came to third grade, I didn't know much about technology, and it's a good experience to learn more about iPads and computers and more, like, technology.
Very cool.
Very nice. Very nice.
Very nice. Very nice.
Here I am with Mrs. Dawson, and I'm going to ask her a question today. So, how hard was it moving from a high ability teacher to a assistant principal?
Well, I'll tell you, Lydia, it was a really hard decision to make. I really, really felt that one of the hardest things was missing the kids, because we were so, we had been together, some of us, since kindergarten, and seeing them every day, it was really hard to leave them. But I knew that they were in good hands with Miss King, so I felt really good about that.
Very nice. Miss Dawson, what is your favorite part about being the assistant principal?
Well, Cole, my favorite part about being the assistant principal is I get to see and work with all students in the school. And it's really exciting to help them do the right thing all day and help them get along with others and just teach them to make sure their behavior is always the best.
Pretty cool.
It's exciting.
Here are some things you can do during summer break. You can do Some Dog on a Weebly page, Rats Kidz, Moby Max, Tumble Books, and other things like that.
And you can have a lot of fun inside.
Woo!
And not have to play outside. Because those are educational. And if they're educational, that's more... That's better than playing outside.
Mm-hmm.
Mm-hmm.
Like a small boat on the ocean, sending big waves into motion. Like how a single word can make a heart open. I might only have one chance, but I can make an explosion. and all the things I didn't say, wrecking balls inside my brain. I will scream them loud tonight. Can you hear my voice this time? This is my fight song. Take back my life song. Prove I'm alright song. My power's turned on. Starting right now, I'll be strong. I'll play my fight song. And it's all I can that nobody else believes. Cause I've still got a lot of fight left in me. Losing friends and I'm chasing sleep. Everybody's worried about me. In too deep, say I'm in too deep. And it's been 2 years, I miss my home. There's a fire burning in my bones. And I still believe, yeah, I still believe. And all those things I didn't say, wrecking balls inside my brain. I will scream them loud tonight. Can you hear my voice this time? This is my fight song. Take back my life song. Prove I'm alright song. Hey, my power's turned on. Starting right now, I'll be strong.
Getting to meet all the students. I'm enjoying meeting all the staff and the parents and the community, and everybody's been so welcoming. And when I first came here, everybody was very gracious to allow me to come into their rooms and into their schools and many times into their businesses, so I've truly enjoyed the people here at Concord.
Nice.
Hello, I'm Lydia, and I'm here with Mr. Trapp, and I'm going to ask him a few questions. So, what does a typical day look like for you, Mr.
Chair? I'm usually up out of bed about 4:30 in the morning. So if it's bad weather or fog or snow, we're out driving the roads with Mr. Tahara, and I do that in the mornings. Like this morning, I got up probably a little earlier than that, and I started going through email and listening to voicemail messages. Got to work today around a little bit before 8 o'clock. I usually have several meetings. I'm here with you today. I have a lot of appointments with teachers and with community members, and enjoy these opportunities to meet with students. Usually in the evenings, I have an activity to go to Last night I went to the senior awards program. I've been to the girls' sectional meet this week. I'm going to the Jazz Cafe on Friday. And so it's usually, I'm usually have something in the evening I'm attending to also.
Very nice.
What technology changes do you see coming to Concord?
In 4 or 5 years, we hope to have a device in every student's hands. So that will put you in junior high or maybe at the beginning of high school. That our goal at that point in time is that every student will have some type of device that they can use every day. In your lives, I think it's really exciting. I can't imagine the technology that you will have in your life and what you'll be able to do. By the time you're getting ready to drive, you'll probably be in a car that will drive itself. So we're trying to prepare you for a life that will that I can't even imagine. And so technology will play a big part in that. We hope to stay up with that.
That sounds like a lot of fun.
Okay,
good. Here I am again with Mr. Chat, and I'm gonna ask him another question. Mm-hmm. So, Mr. Chat, do you like being the superintendent?
Oh, very much. This has been very rewarding for me. When I started working 32 years ago, I never dreamed that this is what I would be doing. But for the last 9 years, this has been my career, and I enjoy this aspect of my job every day. So it's a challenge. No 2 days are the same. And I enjoy it each and every day.
Very cool.
Time to